Welcome to Channel 18 News. I'm Jim Rogers. For Hopkins County, we are under a tornado watch until 10 p.m. Friday evening. We are also under a flood watch along the South Sulphur River until Sunday night at midnight. Just want you to be aware. We mark the passing of Dr. Dan Jones, age 64. Dr. Jones, president of Texas A&M Commerce. He passed away Friday morning. Jones is survived by a wife and two daughters. The cause of his death is unknown at this time. The campus at Texas A&M University Commerce mourning his passing. Jeffrey Eugene Dixon II pled true to family violence by choking or impeding breathing, a felony three. A second family violence that did not include choking, but a felony three, was dismissed in a plea agreement Thursday afternoon. This is Dixon's second trip to prison in the Texas Department of Criminal Justice. If he commits any kind of family violence in the future, whether a misdemeanor or a felony, he'll face 25 years to life in prison. Raul Picardo pled guilty to aggravated sexual assault of a child. Picardo's victim was a young teenaged male who is also a juvenile defendant in cases involving the child as a predator of sexual assault on children. This unique situation and circumstance surrounding Picardo's plea led the district attorney's office to see this as a win in that he received 10 years deferred, 180 days in county jail, added to his time currently served in county jail, and he will also have a lifetime of registration as a sex offender should he return to the United States. He's being held in the local jail for the 180 days, then he'll be turned over to federal authorities for deportation to Mexico. If you steal something in Hopkins County, it may have a tracking device that will lead local law enforcement to the location of the item taken and lead to the arrest of the one or ones who removed the item, according to Hopkins County Chief Investigator Lewis Tatum. Tatum's statement is based on an arrest that was made Friday morning just past the Hopkins County line in Raines County. Ryan Rogers, age 40, and Patricia Rogers, age 33, of Cookeville, no relation to the individual telling you the news today, were booked into Hopkins County Jail after they took an item that had been parked on the side of a Hopkins County road. The item was had a tracking device on it. After taking the device, the man and wife began their journey home, only to have sheriff's deputies begin pursuit. The pair turned down a dead-end road near Lake Fork, where they were arrested. This is not the first time the pair was thought to have taken an item from Hopkins County. A couple of weeks ago, according to Tatum, a Van Zandt County deputy found a trailer that had been taken from Hopkins County parked in their front yard. At that time, they told Van Zandt authorities they didn't know how the trailer had come to be in their yard. Kevin Woolley, superintendent of Saltillo Independent School District, has announced his retirement plans following the end of his contract on June 30th. He was offered a position with the Mount Sylvan Baptist Church in Lindale as music minister and has decided to accept that position. Woolley plans to continue directing the Haystack Youth Choir in Hopkins County and to continue other community involvement that he has here. Woolley told KSST News that his 32 years in education, including the past 6 years as Saltillo ISD principal and superintendent, have been a blessing to his life. He's made many good friends through Saltillo schools, and he and his wife Julie do not plan to move out of the county. To see this story and the official press release from Saltillo schools, go to kssdradio.com. Early voting is underway in the Sulphur Springs City Council election, and early voting continues through Tuesday, May 4th, with Election Day Saturday, May 7th. Emily Glass, Mayor Pro Tem, urges Sulphur Springs citizens to cast their ballot in the election. Glass has served 3 years and is ending her first term on the council. She's seeking re-election to place 5 on the council. She told KSST News Friday morning that during her time in office, the downtown area has become self-sufficient with a TIF tax that was implemented to pay for the continued maintenance of the downtown area. And she said that the vision for Sulphur Springs is now extending across the city.
We are halfway through the early voting portion. People still have an opportunity, though, to early vote today from 8 to 5 at City Hall on the second floor in the executive chambers. Early voting will go through Tuesday of next week, 8 to 5, both days, Monday and Tuesday. And Election Day will be May 7th from 7 a.m. until 7 p.m., and that will be held at the Sulphur Springs ISD Admin Building on Conley Street.
And early voting is at City Hall?
City Hall on the second floor, yes.
Obviously, you are in a race.
I am.
For your position.
I am.
Let's talk about the fact that, how many years have you served in?
I have served 3 years. This is ending my first term on City Council.
Okay. What do you see as the biggest accomplishment during that 3-year period?
Oh my goodness, the biggest accomplishment. We've seen really a turn away from solely downtown, because downtown is now very self-sustaining. We have implemented a TIF tax, so that as the values of the buildings in downtown increase, we are able to in turn use that money to keep downtown going for the mowing of the grass or the cleaning of the bathrooms. It's such a tourist attraction. But most recently, I'm very proud of what we have done. We're overhauling Phil Bradford completely, which has been long overdue, very needed. With that, it's going to have sewer and water, because streets, I mean, when they need to be done, it's a very long-term goal. It's not something that we can do within just a couple of months unless it's just a patch job. But beyond that, we are looking to improve on the south side of the interstate. We have just completed some water and sewerage drains that have changed direction. That's going to allow for more restaurants to go over on the south side of the interstate, which is perfect for the chains in particular, because they're able to get people off of the interstate to eat there.
And so it sounds as though that a vision is being built for the continuance of the redo of Sulphur Springs?
Absolutely, absolutely. Downtown really is the heart and soul of any town, and so now we're able to take that vision and to continue to expand it in all areas of the town, which is really exciting to see.
Having changed locations due to rain here, what do you see as a priority if you serve on council again? All right.
I think really a huge priority for me personally is making sure that I'm keeping in mind I'm representing everybody. I'm not here as Emily Glass as an individual, but I'm here to represent the entire city. Because we are different from commissioners, we don't have an area of the city that we only serve. I still serve, even as Place 5, everybody within the entire city. So that's a very big priority. That's my biggest priority, to be honest, on City Council.
You were endorsed by Law Enforcement Association here.
I was. I'm very grateful for that endorsement. They are a wonderful group of men and women, and their endorsement means a lot to me.
Obviously, they feel that you have given them support this time.
I feel very supported by and supportive of law enforcement in general. They are clearly with the county, so they really don't have a dog in this race, so to speak, but our own police officers and firefighters and personnel of the city, they have a very hard job day in and day out, and I'm very supportive of them. I appreciate everything they do. This city would not be a quarter of what it is without them. We were ranked the number 30th safest city in the state of Texas, and it's because of all of their efforts in keeping us safe. It's an awesome accomplishment.
Anything else you want to say?
I would appreciate everybody to take the time to go out and vote. This is a wonderful civic right that we have here in the United States of America. It's very important that your voice is heard, and this is one way that you're able to get your thoughts out there. So thank you very much, and I hope to see you all on Election Day.
With the cutting of a ribbon and the grand opening of the new PJC Sulphur Springs campus located on Loop 301 in the newly remodeled building that once housed Foxworth Galbraith Lumber Company, Paris Junior College President Pam Anglin's vision for expansion of educational opportunities in the region took one more step forward with the new and modern facility for learning. Anglin told KSST News that the junior college experience in both academic and technology play a vital role in rural Texas, yet she's concerned about the future thanks to the Texas legislature's cuts in funding for junior colleges. She's working on a proposal that shows leadership and vision. For more on this story, see KSSTradio.com.
Dr. Matthew Johnson of Summit Dental in Sulphur Springs is teaming up with a half dozen other local dentists for Dentistry from the Heart. It's an annual dental mission in Sulphur Springs for local adults in need of dental work. The day of free dentistry is Friday, May 6th at Summit Dental. And Dr. Johnson stopped by to tell us about it.
We actually want to emphasize the community of dentists that are coming together that day, a week from today, and coming together for a common goal.
Dentistry from the Heart is not anything we thought up here local. We kind of joined in.
That's correct. We'd really like the philosophy, the delivery model. This guy, this dentist in Florida, I forget where in Florida, but anyway, in Florida, he just thought about this way that he could take care of his community of patients or his own community in his own way, instead of being forced upon to take care of other individuals by the government or whatever type of program. It's his way of taking care of his community on his terms. So it's perfect for our community.
Okay, so we sort of are following a pattern. This is going to be the fourth year local?
Correct, correct.
Okay. Let's set the basis for how people can take advantage of this free dental work that one day only. It's going to be all day long. You're going to have a bunch of people working.
That's correct.
The work will be done on May 6th.
Correct. We sign up or have people sign up by 6 a.m. at Davis Street Baptist Church at the Family Life Center. You can get there a little bit beforehand, of course. Several people do throughout the night, and there will be people ministering to folks that do want to get there early. And then from Davis Street Baptist Church, people will be shuttled over to our office, Summit Dental, where we will be awaiting.
Okay. So you have, of course, your staff and volunteers are going to help in all this scheduling and making sure it flows well.
Correct. The respective dentist that will be here on that Friday will also bring their staff.
Okay.
Our staff mainly provide a support role for them, but everybody brings because they're more comfortable with their own staff, so it's wonderful. But they're on their free time. They're donating their time. Last year, we saw over 100 people donated more than $40,000. In dentistry, and it's actually a blessing to us as well. The energy that's there, it's just a great day.
Well, getting this needed work done is sometimes maybe out of people's reach, pocketbook wise. They will want to get signed up so that they're sure to be in that loop on May 6th.
Yes, yes. There's a whenever we see people, a lot of them really, they could get all their teeth removed because they're in so much pain. We take care of as many teeth as we can during that one visit. We definitely want to see as many people as we can as well.
Okay. Well, and certainly, as you mentioned, you're not doing this all by yourself.
Right. That's right. We've got wonderful people. We've got, if I could go down the list, of Dr. Danny Lawrence, Dr. Daniel Sirafongs, Dr. Dan Roper, a lot of Dans in there, Dr. Sharon Hatcher, Dr. Pravina is going to be here, Dr. David Martinez, Dr. Julie Royston, and of course, myself.
Hmm. So they can sign up starting at any time in the evening, let's say?
Well, when people get there at Davis Street Baptist Church, they will be handed a number, but you have to be there throughout the night in order to stay in line, so to speak. But once you get your number there, you're free to go about the Family Life Center there throughout the night. But at I think around 4 or 5 a.m., there's another roll call that people need to be there in order to line up at 6 o'clock. And our folks, a couple of our ladies will be over there to make the official list and the schedule.
Well, all right. And so your teamwork there with Davis Street Baptist Church is going to come in real handy.
Correct.
Well, somewhere in your press release that I first read about this, it says 101 patients.
Yeah, I don't know why we got. I don't know.
Okay.
I don't know with a 101. Maybe it's because we saw right at 100 last year, so we want to do better this next year. 101. We've got 7 or 8 dentists, and I think it's a great. Our knuckles are dragging at the end of the day, but it's a good kind of tired.
What sorts of work will you do?
Basically, taking teeth out for people that are in pain, but we also fix a lot of teeth as well. We'd rather fix teeth if we can than take teeth out, but of course we want to address anybody that's in pain, but mainly fixing teeth if we can do that.
Okay, so fillings.
We don't do any, of course, dentures or crowns or no root canals, nothing like that, and we mainly target adults as well.
Okay, all right. So we've mentioned the dentists who will be helping out and their staff, so you'll have like an army of people working at this.
Oh, there's volunteers all over the place. Yeah, we have different sponsors. Coffee Off the Square is going to be providing breakfast for us, and then Alliance Bank is going to be cooking for us. We've got other sponsors that have donated money, Germania, Outback Construction, Bering Construction. We've got several other sponsors.
Okay. Well, I know that dentists, of course, do a lot of repair work for people and relieving pain, but the main thing you try to preach is prevention.
Correct. Correct. And we'll be preaching that as well. Everybody's going to get a goodie bag with all kinds of toothbrushes and floss and toothpaste in there. So that is the key. You can keep your teeth for a long, long time if you just play the prevention game.
Okay. And, of course, that would put you out of work if no one needed dental care.
Well, that's correct. But, hey, you know, there's always people going to be drinking Dr. Pepper and Gatorade and not brushing. But we still emphasize that. We still preach every day about the importance of keeping teeth. But actually, people are losing their teeth these days, not because they're getting decayed so much, but because of gum disease. So we have to stay on top of gum disease, too. And that's why we have hygienists to prevent gum disease.
Certainly. Well, tell me how you came to be a dentist and your background.
I've wanted to be a dentist ever since I was in 10th grade. I had a wonderful teacher, a biology teacher, that she just instilled us the passion to learn. And I loved science. I loved art. I loved people. I wanted to be my own boss. So kind of everything steered or focused on, hey, you know, what about dentistry? And so I haven't regretted it.
Where are you from and where did you go to school?
Actually, I've got family from here. My mother's side, family, the Pruitt and Wilson. I'm related to Rick Wilson here and Sharon Wilson. And so my family from distant relatives are from here from over 100 years ago, but I grew up in Conroe, Texas. Went to college at Hardin-Simmons University where I played soccer and then went to San Antonio to dental school and went to Charleston, South Carolina at the VA hospital there for residency. And then I was up in Montana for a few years in the 90s. I was a commissioned officer with the Public Health Service on an Indian reservation.
Very interesting work.
And then been here since 99.
Okay. And dentistry from the heart is something that Dr. Matthew Johnson really embraces, as well as some of our other dentists here in town. All that work is going to be done on May the 6th.
Correct.
So why Summit Dentistry as your headquarters?
Well, we have a pretty good sized building over there. We've got a total of 7 working operatories, and we actually have 2 more that we use just for a triage room. So it flows really well. We've got it down to science. As far as patient coming in, we take their x-rays, then we disperse them to whatever room, whatever dentist is there with their staff, and then they can go out the side door. So the flow of traffic is just conducive to have everybody there.
Okay. And your location there on Church Street, easy to find here in town?
We used to be on Church Street, actually, north side of town.
I meant to say Oak
Avenue, yes. Yeah, 422 Oak Avenue. That's correct. That's where we're at.
And your building, I went there the other day to talk to you, and it's just beautiful. The walkways, the landscaping, it's just a lovely place.
Well, thank you. Appreciate that. My dad did that, actually. My dad and I designed that and put the plants in. We don't take care of it like we should, but we have other folks to do that. But we enjoy that. The design, of course, took 5 years before we built it. And we wanted to fit in the community as far as Oak Avenue and some of the houses along Swiss Avenue in Dallas. And we modeled after that. I think it's called a ranch house style. And so we love it.
It's beautiful. If you haven't been to Summit Dentistry, do so. And tell me, in your practice, just speaking of your practice, you do all ages?
Right, correct. We love kids. I mean, I'm almost 50. I know I don't look like it, but I'm almost 50. But we love kids, and they provide a lot of energy for us. But we see adults, too. As a matter of fact, we are doing more and more and more implant-related procedures because of our baby boomers. As we increase in maturity, some of our folks are losing teeth, and so therefore implants are extremely popular these days. You may have heard the commercials, Clear Choice, All on 4, that kind of stuff. So we're doing a lot more implants with dentures these days.
Okay, well, whole range of dentistry offered at Summit Dental, and especially now this community project. And for those who might have just tuned in, we have just a few more moments. Will you just kind of give us a recap on your May 6th event?
Sure. This is something that we're very passionate about. It's a way for us to deliver care and make a difference in our community. We want to do that on our terms, and it does. It makes a great difference in our own county. But we sign up, or have folks sign up by 6 a.m. at Davis Street Baptist Church over there at the Family Life Center, and then they'll be shuttled, provided by the vans will be provided by the church, and then we just have people come in, we greet them, we want to treat them like kings and queens, minister to them. We're also emphasizing it's going to be a faith-based. That's also another thing that we like about it on our terms, is that we're going to pray with folks. So we're going to take care of their physical needs and their spiritual needs, too.
Okay, it is a mission, really.
Correct. It's a mission right here in town.
Well, we thank you for offering this to people.
You bet.
And as we've been discussing this, in order to secure a place in line, maybe you need to get over there during the night on Friday, May the 5th. Is that right?
Correct. Thursday night, May the 5th, people start lining up. And that's great. Come on. The doors will be open all night long, and drop by, and there may be some movies. And
okay.
Hopefully not a lot of candy. There to get ready to see the dentist. But anyway, there will be some refreshments there as well.
Thank you for the service that you are offering.
Thank you.
Here's Don Julian with sports. The Lady Cats softball team trailed early but rallied to take a 9-4 win over Corsicana in game one of a bi-district series at Lady Cat Park Thursday night. After the game, I talked with Lady Cat softball coach David Carrillo.
Doubts tonight after a four-run deficit there?
Actually, no, not really. I felt like our kids have been very resilient. We've been through so much this year, and, you know, I just told them to keep their heads up. You know, even in the first inning when I went to the mound and made a visit, I said, hey, four runs ain't going to beat us. You know, we kind of made some mistakes, you know, in the field and did some things that are uncharacteristic of us. But you know what? They battled back. Landry ended up throwing up three great more innings, and, you know, Bailey came in and finished it off. So, you know, what more can you ask from those two? You know, they've really stepped up their game the last few games, and you know, I'm very proud of our pitching, our hitting, timely hitting. You know, it took a little while to get going, but you know, we got the right hits at the right time when we needed it. And again, you know, Hannah does her thing, Alyssa does her thing. You know, then we just clean them up and knock them in. So, you know, I was very pleased. Our girls know it's a series. I always tell them, hey, a series is the name of a series for a reason. So, you know, we still got to win one whenever we do play again. But, again, I'm so proud of these girls. They've been through a lot, and they've battled and battled. And, you know, they're just resilient. And what more can you say about them? Very proud.
Yeah, I kind of compared them to that old diesel engine, you know, kind of slow starting in the morning. But man alive, you know, they really, the big four runs in the fifth inning, four runs in the sixth. Kristen Allen cleans the bases just to blow the game.
Yes, and I believe she got two hits tonight, and all, two big hits. And, you know, Kristen's a great high school hitter. You know, she's just solid all the way around. Her swing is very, you know, very precise. And, you know she's going to hit the ball and do some damage, you know. And like I said, what more can you say about her? She's a great team player, and I love Kristen. She does a good job for us. And, you know, speaking of old jalopies, I think that's the way our field is. You know, we had to prime it and get started, but it held up. So, you know, it was good. It was a lot of work. But we did it, so we're very proud. Girls are proud. I knew it was important for them to. They wanted to really play at home, so we did whatever we could to make it happen. So you know, we're very blessed. Very blessed.
Yeah, when you see weather like we expect for the next couple of days, man, winning and being one ahead 1-0, this win was huge.
Yes, it was. It was. And, you know, I was kind of thinking that in the back of my mind, and I believe we talked about it earlier today, you know, just even for your confidence, you know, level, you know, because we've the last few years we've lost the first game, and, you know, we've kind of felt like we've had to battle back in playoff series. But, you know, to get the first one, you know, they're going to sleep well tonight, and we're going to get it all figured out how to take game two and take care of business, and you know, not let this thing linger much longer, you know. And then if the rain comes, you know, it comes. So we just got to see. Again, we just got to be very very flexible in our schedule, and I already explained that to them, so we'll be fine.
Very nice win. This is what 27 wins feels like, coach.
Yeah, thank you. 27. Yeah, it's amazing, and it's gone so fast. And like I said, the kids, it's all about them. They've done a great job this year. I'm very proud of them. You know, they, like I said, they've been through some stuff, have been very resilient, and you know, just believed, you know, there is a plan. And again, you're playing for something more, and they're just hanging in there doing that. So, you know, we're very blessed.
Thanks for watching Channel 18 News. Have a great evening.